If you want to maximize alerting functionality in NT8, then set some pretty cool and unconventional alerting types in the platform that are extremely useful, then this is what you've been waiting for. So let's get started. Just before I begin, I do want to just mention that we have two tools for NT8 that are totally free and very useful. One draws a price line across your chart, and the other one draws upcoming news releases as well as previous news releases for that week directly on your charts too. So you can get both of those at xabcdtrading.com and would be useful no matter what strategy you use. Now, on to the good stuff. People use alerts to save themselves time, but they can also be used for other reasons too. We're going to teach you how to set up alerts at price levels or when certain conditions happen within an indicator, or if your profit hits more than X dollars, or at the start of a new session. There's all kinds of crazy ways to do alerts. So let's start showing you different methods that you can use one by one. Now, there are two main ways that you can create alerts. The first is by right-clicking on an object and then going into the alerts on the chart, okay? The other one is through the market analyzer and right clicking within the table and going to the alerts that way. So let's tackle the charts first. And the cool thing with the market analyzer, we can do that in just a minute. Say there's a specific point on the chart where price goes to that area, we want to get an alert. The first thing that we want to do is take out a drawing tool, and it works with any of them. So I'm going to pick this circle as an example. So right click on that object that you just drew in, and in this case, the circle, and we'll go to the menu item alerts. Okay, stop here for a sec. Okay, we need to explain this alert screen, and then you can know what you're going to do every time you see the screen again in the future. So we're only going to review this one, so just pay close attention. The left-hand side is going to be where we have a list of all our conditions. So by default, most of the time this will be filled out the way that you want it, but let's read through it once together so we're on the same page. Okay, so the data series for this alert is going to be the same as the chart that we're looking at here. Okay, so if price crosses inside of that drawing object, which is what the ellipse is, or the circle that we drew, if price crosses inside that, then, and we can configure what's going to happen after we hit OK. So select OK. So everything here got filled out pretty much for us. Starting at the top, the alert is enabled. The name was provided, although you can change that. The rearming type is just what happens after the alert is triggered and when it would be triggered again. Okay. By default, this is going to never alert once it got alerted to once. Now we have the conditions that we filled out for the previous screen. So this was already done for us. It says that the chart price crosses inside our ellipse shape, then it's going to perform the following actions. So first we have the message text that will be displayed so that you can fill that in. Clicking the down arrow will give you added shortcuts with dynamic data. Okay, so the priority is just a way for you to say how important it is, because in the alert log, which we'll show you in a sec, you can sort by priority. Okay, then you can add a color for the alert log. Okay, or the foreground, the background, change any of those. And we can finally get into the good stuff now with the actions. The actions is where we can select to play a sound or show a pop-up or send ourselves an email. So click that add button in the bottom right underneath actions. Now you can pick the type of action you want to have happen. So don't forget, if you choose the share a message, these services have to be set up beforehand, before you do this from the control center. So just press OK when you're done. So you can have multiple messages types. For instance, you can play a sound and have a pop-up box, or you can send an email and have a notification alert. Okay, so get creative and play around with these. If you have any questions, ask in the comments below the video. To choose this alerting option, okay, just save your changes, whatever you had in there in the bottom right, and just press OK. Okay, so now here's the cool thing. If you want to resize or change the shape of this object in any way, okay, your alerts can adjust for the new shape automatically. So if the market changes and you want to make the circle wider, not a problem. Okay, once price crosses inside, you will still already get the alert because it was already configured. The second main way to configure alerts is going to be through your market analyzer. So let's pull that up. Let's say you want to create an alert if one trade makes more than $1,000. Okay, so you want to get notified of that. How do you do that? So first we need to add one column to the market analyzer that isn't there right now. And to get that data that we want to actually get alerted to, which is how much money we've made so far, to check to see if we've made more than $1,000. Okay, so that is our unrealized profit or loss column that we need to add. So to do this, we need to right click on the market analyzer and go down to columns. Underneath the available columns to choose, scroll down until you see unrealized profit or loss. Okay, double click on that and we'll add it to the configured columns below. And you will want to make sure that the right account is selected. Okay, we're going to use a demo account for this. So I'll use my third simulation account. You'll find a link to a video down in the description if you're not sure how to set up multiple demo accounts, just so you can try this out. Now press OK to save this new column and right click on the market analyzer again. This time we're going to select alerts. Okay, we'll add a new one by clicking on the add button underneath the configured list of alerts. We'll want this alert to be enabled, and I'm going to call it my profit loss 1000 alert. Okay, now once it triggers, I'm going to have it wait 86,400 seconds, which are how many seconds are in one day, and then alert me again to the same condition. Okay, so now for those conditions. Click on the add button underneath the conditions and select the unrealized profit loss column. So if the unrealized profit loss column value is greater or equal to a numerical value of 1000, then send me an alert. So that's it. I mean, your alert's been created and now you can press OK. You will see it listed in the configured alerts, and then you'll want to press OK to close that alert screen. You'll want to leave your market analyzer running, so now when you add instruments, it will alert you every time you make more than $1,000 off each trade. So these are the two main ways that you're going to be using alerts to trigger, okay? There is one more, and that is pretty critical. It's called your alert window. And I want you to go back into the control panel and select new and then alerts log. So this is going to be a list of your alerts with, by default, the newest alert is going to be on top. And you can also color code these in the alert setting that we were setting up where all your actions were. You can actually color code the alerts that when you set them up in that alert configuration box, and you can even kind of sort them here to show you just high, medium, or low events. So there's a few neat little things that you can do with this window. Now, like I was saying before, one of the cool tools that we have is this premium news indicator that maps out news events directly on your charts. So inside that, we also have alerts configured, similar with how we're teaching you now, that will actually run before a pending news event item, right? So that way you can be alerted to the news maybe like an hour ahead of time, so you have a chance to tighten up stops or make some last minute adjustments. It's totally up to you on how long you want to be alerted to before that news, but the fact is that you can get alerts now for pending news events. So if you're just wanting to see some of the news events without all the alerts, you can, you know, download the free tool. It doesn't alert you, but it does put it on your screen. And that's from xabcdtrading.com. And while you're there, don't forget to grab that price line indicator too. I certainly hope that you have learned something about these alerts. And if you have, please leave us a comment as well, because we love to hear from you guys. Or simply just whack that thumbs up button. We'll see you guys soon in the next video.